A large tank is filled with two liquids of specific gravities, 2 sigma and sigma. Two holes are made on the wall of the tank as shown. Find the ratio of the distances from O of the points on the ground where the jets from the holes A and B strike. First of all, understand that this entire tank is filled with the two liquids of different densities. The density of the liquid at the bottom is double that of the first. So let us first calculate the velocity of the jet that is from the first stream, okay? The velocity of the jet from the first stream. It will simply be equal to V1 is equal to root 2 GH. So it will be equal to root 2 G, and the height above this point will be equal to H by 4, okay? It's a straightforward one, okay? Let this be equation number 1. I will use this later. Now, in order to get the velocity of the jet from the second stream, that is from this point, let the velocity over here be V2 from the second stream. I can say that the total pressure energy from the top will be equal to the kinetic energy at the second point. So what is the pressure energy at the top? It will be equal to sigma G H by 4, sigma G H by 2, because of this entire liquid section. And due to this liquid section over here, it will be equal to 2 sigma into G into H divided by 4, okay? So it will be equal to half, and the liquid that is pouring out of the second jet, okay, is of density 2 sigma. So it will be equal to half 2 sigma into V square, okay, or V2 square, okay? So basically it will be equal to the sigma will get cancelled out everywhere. Sigma will get cancelled over here, 2 over here will get cancelled out. So it will be equal to GH by 2 plus GH by 2, which is equal to GH. So over here, V2 square is equal to GH, or V2 will be equal to root GH. Let this be equation number 2. Let us find out the distances at which they land on the ground. If I consider this as the ground over here, the first jet will come somewhat like this, okay, performing a projectile motion. The height above the ground will be equal to 3h by 4. Okay, its height above the ground will be equal to 3h by 4. So let us first calculate the time required in order to travel this height vertically. Okay, so s is equal to ut. We will use the equation s is equal to ut plus half at square. We will use the same equation for both of them. So I can say that s over here will be equal to total displacement in the vertical is equal to 3h by 4. Is equal to initial velocity over here is equal to 0 in vertical. Half G T1 square. Let this be equation number 3. And similarly, for the second jet, the height over here above the ground, the height above the ground will be equal to H by 4. Okay. The height above the ground will be equal to H by 4. So it will be equal to, I will use the same equation, H by 4 will be equal to half G T2 square. Let this be equation number 4. I can say that if I equate both of them, I can say that T1 square will be equal to 3 times T2 square, which implies T1 is equal to root 3 times T2, okay? T1 is equal to root 3 times T2. Let us calculate the horizontal distance. In order to calculate the horizontal distance, okay, in the horizontal, since there is no acceleration, the horizontal distance of the first one, let it be equal to x1, it will be equal to v1 into T1, and the horizontal distance of the second will be equal to V2 into T2. So when I take the ratio x1 by x2, it will be equal to V1 divided by V2. Now V1 over here is equal to root GH by 2. Okay, it is equal to, or it will be equal to root GH by 2. And over here, in the second case, it is simply equal to root GH. Okay. Time for the first one, I can say that T1 is equal to root 3 times T2. So I will substitute root 3 times T2 divided by T2. So T2 will get cancelled out over here. This part will get cancelled out, root GH will get cancelled out. So if I calculate the ratio, x1 by x2 will come out to be root 3 divided by 2. This will be the ratio of the horizontal distances travelled by both the jets.